You know, I had my brothers and sisters who would tell me, you know, why are you listening to that white boy music, you know? I'd hear that, and my mom would always yell at him and tell him, you know, leave him alone. Let him listen to what he wants to listen to. It all started with Hee Haw, because Roy Clark and Buck Owens were the guys that, I mean, every Saturday at 6 o'clock, I was watching Hee Haw. It was the one thing that the family knew, don't come and, you know, go to the other TV because Darius is going to be watching Hee Haw. And I also had AM radio, which was great. And, you know, you'd be sitting there at night and you're flipping through the channels and you could pick up stations from Tennessee and stations from all over the Southeast. And I loved it. When I started this country thing, I didn't care what, you know, people thought. If I ever really sat down and thought about what people think of my career or what I've done, I don't think I could have ever made it. I think I was doing the Opry or something, and somebody came up to me and said, you know, you're the first African-American since Charlie Pride to have a top 25 country hit. And it was a great moment. It was, I felt so validated at that point. It was just like, that's awesome. I think it's just been the way it is for so long that people just didn't think, you know, an African-American kid, especially an African-American kid that comes from a, you know, rock pop band, could make it. And thank goodness they were wrong. When I went to South Carolina, my plan was to major in broadcast journalism, maybe someday be a sportscaster or something. But I met the guys in Hootie, and you know, life was changed after that. I sang all the time, and I didn't think about it. It was just something I did. I walked around and I sang. And one day I was singing in the shower, and I came out of the shower, and Mark Bryan, the guitar player in Hootie, lived in my dorm hall, and he said, "Man, was that you singing?" I was like, "Yeah, that was me." He's like, "He sounded good." I was like, "Thanks." He said, "Why don't you come by my room, see if we know any of the same songs?" So I went by his room, and we realized we knew about 20 songs that he knew and that I knew, and we started a band pretty much that day. The Hootie and the Blowfish name, when I named the band, I didn't think that people would think I was Hootie. I don't know why I didn't think that, but I didn't think that at all. And so there was a time when the record really took off and you know, people were calling me Hootie, I realized, you know, why didn't I name the band, you know, the Darius Rucker Band or something? I mean, it was a thing. But then when I looked at it, I thought, you know, I wouldn't change the name for anything, because, you know, like it or hate it, you never forgot it. Once you heard the name Hootie and the Blowfish, you never forgot it. And so that's what you want to do with a band name, and so it worked for us. My first big paycheck when we got signed and they sent the money, the first thing I did was pay off my student loans. That was just, I was so tired of writing those checks and getting those things in the mail about, you know, you owe us more money. So the first thing I did was pay off my, I didn't even buy a car. I paid off my student loans. That was all I wanted to do.